Hey guys, today's video is a little bit different. I'd like to talk about my development story. We always make something with hardware, but where is the end? How far should you go to make really the end of the project? Well, to answer this question, I'm trying to develop software and applications starting with the hardware level. To be honest, it's not easy work. Absolutely not. I also spend lots of time and effort planning and working on a project. Still, I'm trying to focus on creating a new value through great project as possible. This project starts with the Mahoney algorithm of the MPU-6050. I hope you guys watched this project. Anyway, the algorithm for obtaining quaternions from MPU-6050 has been used for a long time. But using the Mahoney algorithm, the quaternion was calculated faster in MCU, and I thought a more interesting project would be possible. So the first time I made is this dice. I was able to express the rotation using the Unity game engine. I thought it would be good to develop dice further and make board games, something like that. But I also judged it was too much to make with the only information of the rotation. Perhaps in the next series, I will make a project with the 9DOF BNO055, in which is we can get information of the absolute position of the sensor. I thought about what kind of the project I should do with the combination of MPU-6050 and ESP32. The rotation information of the device is very useful, but feels a little bit lacking when making a game. So what I thought of was the fishing game. I thought it'd be good to reel in and out something by using the rotation of the fishing reel. At this time, I decided to make a game with the Unity game engine. The first thing I did was model the fishing rod for the game. Since I'm not a 3D modeler, I'm not good at handling 3D tools such as Blender and Maya. So I made the fishing rod using the magical voxel. It's working in the pixel unit, so anyone can make their 3D model in the easiest way. After making the fishing rod, I had to prepare the most important thing, the fishing line. When the reel was rotated, the fishing line had to be rolled up or released. This part was resolved using a rope asset purchased from the Unity asset store. This concept is nothing special and has been in the game for a long time. And also there's a Nintendo rubber strings. They created a new value by combining it with a hot paper and their controller called Joy-Con. Personally, it's really great. I think we are living in the era where new ways of thinking change the world. It's impossible to create the same system as a rubber strings, but I aim to make it similar using all the resources I have. Among the rubber strings, the fishing rod is complete here. Originally, we need to put the Joy-Con of the Nintendo Switch, but I will put the board I made. It was a good idea to make a connector below the board. It's not perfectly fixed, but it does not fall out. This is enough. Also, put the battery in the empty space below and connecting the cable, then it's done. This is simply a paper fishing rod, but it can be a great frame as the controller. This paper fishing rod is bigger than I thought. I can expand the top part, but it's still big enough, so I will keep it like this. It doesn't matter. Let's go back to Unity and see how it organized. There is a rotation part I'd like to explain. Here is a project I prepared. I will briefly explain the rotating part only. If you look at the game screen below, there is a camera looking at the fishing rod from above. And there is another camera looking at the fishing rod from the side on the screen. The body part of the fishing rod moves from side to side, and the rear part only rotates on the spot. The gizmo box in the middle shows how the hardware device is currently rotating. First, if you look at the rear rotator, using this to rotate the x-axis of the reel. When the x-axis rotates in the positive direction, it's pulled, and if it's the opposite, loosen the string. The reel controller is the controller responsible for these two parts of the rotations. Let me show you the source code. Also, you can find the project link under the description. Here are two scripts. ESP32 BLEF on the left and rear controller on the right. When the BLE is connected and subscribed correctly, the quaternion value is updated to the rear controller. If you need, please refer to the previous project regarding VRD connection in Unity. What we need to see is update quaternion function. Let's think the hardware sensor is in the form of a sphere. I want to find the degree of the rotation only for specific axis, but I can't simply find the degree of the rotation because the perspective of the sphere changes every time it rotates. Vector 3 sine angle is being used to calculate the direction of the rotation. Rather than just looking at the rotation on the x-axis, you need to set the rotating axis and look at the direction in which it rotates, so that you can obtain the rotation values for a particular direction even if sensor is flipped. To determine the degree of the rotation, always need to store the previous value because it's compared to the previous value. The x-axis must continue to add the rotated value to wind or loosen. So the value continues to be added to the rotated around x. The y-axis is the part that rotates the body. This part also calculates the degree of the rotation of the particular axis. Determine which direction you are currently rotating by obtaining the degree of the rotation. If there is a rest movement, we can say it's idle. The reason why I doubled it here is to make the x-axis spin more sensitively. When the sphere rotates, no matter how it moves in the certain direction, it affects the other angles. To solve this problem, I made them do only one action at a time. The part that moved the body need to be calculated one more time. First, we can know which direction is rotated to the y-axis. This is not an absolute rotation, but a relative rotation compared to the previous rotation. So to rotate the actual body part, we have to change it to the absolute value. The real controller itself is currently spinning with the quaternion from the hardware. So compare the y-axis of the Euler rotation of the real controller to obtain a relative rotation that is currently rotated. And then adding this rotation value to the current y-axis rotation, we can get the absolute value that should be rotated. Please leave a comment if there is a better way. In this part, in order to reduce the movement of the cube hanging from the end of the line, the velocity is reduced and the force is applied in the reverse direction. This is all how I control this fishing rod with quaternion from MPU6050. Let me show you how it works now. Here you are. If I move the paper fishing rod from side to side, the virtual fishing rod also moves from side to side. I can release or wind up the rope by turning the handle knob. There's a status indicator on the upper right corner of the screen, so we can see the current status of the movement. When turning the reel, the rotation of the fishing rod's body is restricted. On the other end, it's reflected in the virtual fishing rod and moved. One thing I couldn't solve was that I couldn't control the elasticity of the rope properly. Although the elasticity is set minimum after looking at the manual of the rope, the end cube hanging at the end of the line still bounced up a lot. I think I need to drill down this part more. Except for this, I think it's ready to use it for the game. This is a very simple game that I have made for demo. The concept is to find and retrieve the treasure in the water. I think I need to spend more time and effort to improve the completeness of this game. It's very simple right now. Avoid shark attacks and rip the gold bar in the water within a certain time frame. When you achieve your goal, the next wave begins and more sharks attack you. I don't have a deployment plan yet. I reckon I need to refine and plan more for this. I'll update you. That's all. Thanks for watching. See you in the next project.